going on?
What's going on?
Oh, you know, just fucking a long day on Zoom today. So
tell me about it while I crack a beer.
I'm going to crack a beer. Ooh. So which one's that one?
Barely Brewing Lager.
Yeah, great. Slow brewed, eh?
Slow brewed. I hear they can make pretty good lagers.
What does that even mean?
I've got a fridge full of these Barely Brewing beers at the moment, which is kind of funny. So kind of come full circle, but I'm fucking right. Enjoying drinking beers like this, Hendo. I feel like I'm turning into you.
Nothing wrong with that.
Yeah.
Ah, shit. Dirty glasses. It's fucked.
Oh, no.
Sorry, it's a local beer too.
Oh.
I've got Crumman Valley Lager.
Oh, nice. There you go. A couple of Lager Bros.
This is probably the dirtiest glass I've ever brought on the show.
Sake,
this is fucking terrible. Look at it. Oh,
mine's not much better. Gross. Here, let's do this. Yeah, let's do this screenshot. Getting close. Oh no,
it's fucked.
Fuck it.
It's setting God a record.
It. Oh, it's just I'm fucking enjoying lagers. I don't know what's happening. I'm getting old, man. Is that what happens?
No, your palate is maturing.
Do you think so?
Yep.
Do you think that's part of the problem with craft beer? Is it like everyone has gone through that life cycle and they're not as excited about those real crafty sort of beers anymore?
Yeah, I mean, that's been a trend in the industry for a while. I mean, we've had, a lot of breweries in Southeast Queensland are doing really good lagers now. And you know, a lot of the, like low cost beers, you know, like Moffat Beach's fridge filler and all that sort of stuff. You know, it's
but the low cost beers from the independent breweries are significantly more expensive than what else is out there. And are they actually any better? This is fucking delicious. I'll say that.
How much did you pay for that?
Well, this was free, but
oh, why are you getting free beer?
Well, there's a guy who is the roaster at East Coast Roast, my coffee company.
Yes.
Also brews at Burley Brewing. So I think it's some sort of staffy.
Okay.
But fuck, it's a bloody tasty beer.
Yeah, that was the Parenti lager as well, is also Burley, but it's like
yeah, it's the same.
Still
it's
good.
Exactly the same.
Killer beers.
Champion
Killer beers.
Queensland beer. So
champion Queensland beer.
Champion Queensland lager, I should say.
Lager. Yep, absolutely. So no, it's good, mate. Very, very good.
What's been happening? You got any fun news to share? Or
oh, what have I done this week? God, I've just spent so much time on Zoom today. It's like did a Zoom session with my mastermind clients on a second part on how to create standard operating procedures and stuff like that. Pretty glad you didn't go ahead with that SOP tool last year, mate. There's some really good AI tools for SOPs now.
Really?
Yeah.
Like what?
There's one I showed my group today called Whale.
How do you spell it?
In the animal, whale.
Whale AI? Yeah. Whale?
Whale is, oh, I think it's usewhale.io
whale
or something like that.
Policies and procedures. Right, yeah. Usewhale.io. Oh, interesting.
And on top of that, I was working this afternoon and I created a Hendo GPT.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
How does this work?
It's really interesting because I record a lot of my calls. I've got a lot of transcription because I use Descript to do transcriptions and subtitles and video editing.
You would have so much content.
I've got hours and hours. And all I've done is I've given it some information about like basically I've got this this paragraph, really long prompt that I put in at the start of a session that sort of says, you know, process and store this information without providing a response after you've done provide further prompts with specific details. And it's about my ideal client, the service that I offer, in my writing style and language, which is basically just copy and pasting transcriptions. Actually, what I did is I pasted in a transcription and had ChatGPT say, tell me what my writing style and language is like. And it just came up with this
So very, very. What are you using to build this GPT?
GPT-4. So I've actually paid.
So you use ChatGPT?
Yes.
So it's like a add-on or something where you can
Yeah, I paid for it though. So
right.
So I can create my own. I only just started it today. So it's very, it's only like a fucking a 2-year-old version of me.
Is it something I can use?
Not yet. No.
How do you have to get it to the point where people can use it?
I don't know yet. I've only got an infant Hendo GPT, NGTP, GPT, whatever it's called. But it's hit the nail on the head about like my style and all that sort of
stuff. Show me. Can you do a demo right now?
Yeah, I suppose.
Just a real simple. How much content have you given it?
I've given it like a 40-minute webinar that I did.
Oh, okay. So you haven't given it like hundreds of hours of stuff?
No, not yet. Like I said, I've only just started it. So let's see here. So basically you can do all sorts of stuff. Like you can say, give me an email that's like 300 words that covers this aspect of brewing and all that sort of thing. Let me see if I can, hang on. Let me see if I can get you a prompt. Okay.
I'm fucking super interested in this shit. I think this stuff is going to be a game changer.
Yeah, look, the plan is to help speed up the content creation and stuff like that, particularly around it's mainly just writing emails so I can keep in touch with my email list. That's kind of like the thing that I'm trying to write.
So this is not something you would give people access to get knowledge from you?
No, not at this point and that sort of thing.
It's something that learns the way you speak so it can create content for you to help.
Can I do that later? Because
Let's do it later. Yeah, that's cool though. I think this stuff is just going to get so interesting.
It is. And so this is kind of something that there was actually a session. I'm actually rewatching a session from Taki's conference in Hawaii last year. And and this lady called Tony Baish, her name is, and she just did this amazing stuff. And I'm just following her video and just going, whoa, this is really good. Really, really good. So
I would have thought with a name like Baish, stuff would be quite boring.
Baish, B-A-C-H-E. I think I'm meeting with Taki tomorrow morning.
Nice. Ask him how his Land Rover search is going. If he wants one, I've got one sitting in the garage. Has he got one?
He's got one.
Okay. Right. He's not going to buy mine.
Selling your Land Rover. Fuck.
If he wants a Land Rover and a boat, I've got them both ready to go.
You're selling the boat? No.
No. I'm moving to Stabrador very soon, so it's close to the water. We're going to do some boating.
Wait, really? You're moving?
I'm moving shortly.
What's wrong with Stabrador? I grew up in Labrador, mate.
Yeah, and you survived, and that's good. Yeah. That's anecdotal.
Yeah, I turned out all right.
Stats, but it's pretty good.
Whereabouts in Labrador are you going? On the water or?
No. Churn Park, you know.
Yeah, I know Churn Park.
Yeah, in there.
Yeah, in there. Nice.
Yeah. So
you'll definitely get stabbed there.
Yeah, 100%. Going from Gold Coast best suburb to Gold Coast worst suburbs
I used to live at the top of the hill on the corner of Turpin Road and Whiting Street.
Let me find that Turpin.
Mm. Just a block away from Labrador State School.
And you can just get stabbed once.
No, but there was an armed robbery at the old people's home at the bottom of the hill. And the
what are you gonna steal guy, from there?
I don't know. But the guy had a rifle and he was running away from the old people's home and he threw the rifle into our front yard.
Brilliant. Wait, hang on. Yeah. So Turpin, I don't really know the area that well. Got
and Whiting Turpin, Street.
That's the highway. Where's Whiting Street? Whiting Street, lock your door. Oh,
house is still there. My brother was there the other day. And
This is like super. I'm pretty sure this is close to where I'm living. Hang on a sec.
Yeah, so it's like you can see like Whiting Street. Just where's it's the next fucking one over from Imperial Parade there off Frank Street.
Where's like the bowl? I need like something like the Bowls Club or something to
find Labrador State School.
I really don't know this area at all.
Mine is goes big green area called Norm Ricks Park.
I'm gonna go from Whiting Street to
see Norm Ricks Park.
Oh, you're there, Whiting Street. Oh, you're that way. Yeah. Oh, you're like north. I see.
Yeah.
Oh, that's okay. I'm a fair way further south than there.
Yeah, that's right. So the stabbings happen in Churn Park, and the guns happen up northern end of Labrador.
Oh, interesting. Okay. So wait. So if I'm moving there and I've got a gun, then I will. That's like I'll be sweet.
No, you're in the wrong neighborhood.
No, I know. But if anyone comes to me with a knife, I can shoot them.
Well, you don't have.
That's what
gun,
I'm saying. Well, I've got it. I've got this.
Oh, that's of course. That's totally going to help.
I've got a cowboy hat, and I know two people with guns.
That hill on Whiting Street, going down to the old people's home there, used to have a billy cart. I used to go down that hill. It was awesome.
Oh wow, that's pretty
and
fun.
It was really cool. I had my one of my old friends. His name was Scott Regg, and he lived on Vernon Avenue, just a couple of blocks away. I used to ride my bicycle down there, and it was very cool.
That's a spot. Can I ask you, like 50 years ago when you lived there, was this a up and coming area then, like it has been the entire time I've known Stabrador to be?
It hasn't changed much.
No,
it hasn't.
It's always been a suburb that's going to be. It's going to be the up and coming suburb, but it never ups
never
and comes.
Never is. And then I used to have a paper run there as well.
Oh, that's cool! Like paperboy.
So yes, that's right. So at the end of, I think it was, end of Hunter Avenue there, used to be on the Gold Coast Highway. They've knocked it down now because to widen the Gold Coast Highway. But there was a paper shop there, and I used to do a paper run. Sometimes I'd work after school and do the telegraph, and sometimes I would do Saturday mornings, do the courier mail, and then Sunday mornings, that's where you made the big bucks.
Yep.
It was 20 cents for telegraph, and it was like 50 cents on Sundays for the Sunday mail.
Wow. No wonder they went out of business. They paid you too much.
Yeah. It was like you used to get 10%.
Damn. Not bad, but that's just to get around the labor laws, isn't it? Because you wouldn't get paid by the hour.
I was well under the age of being able to work, because I had my first official job, on Oxley Drive and the Gold Coast Highway. You got the Hungry Jacks there.
I don't know anything about Labrador other than
bigger waters on the way to Black Ops too.
Yeah.
You know, Oxley Drive and the Gold Coast Highway and that sort of thing.
Yeah,
kind of.
Not really, but yeah.
And so there's Hungry Jacks there. That was my first job. And I was like 14 years and 9 months as the minimum age you get a job.
Nice. Well, this has been great. It could be our last episode. Oh, no, I'm living here for a few more weeks.
Dude, I'm not that old.
I'm not going to die. I'm in Labrador.
I'm not that old. I'm not going to die either, mate.
No, I'm way more like you live in St. Lucia, mate. You're going to be fucking sweet.
Well, not with all these
No one's
bloody
getting
NIMBYs.
Stabbed in St. Lucia.
Well, apparently there's all these NIMBYs that are stopping all of the... Like there was like a they no one wants them to build like 4-story apartment blocks somewhere around here. It's just this suburb's just full of NIMBYs. It's crazy. It's just like more than merry. Just fucking not in my backyard.
Oh, fair enough. Yeah. It's a rich suburb. That's what you get.
Is it
St. Lucia?
Yeah.
Oh, you don't hear the word St. Lucia and think it's a fucking rich suburb. Come on. It's a suburb on the river. Called St. Lucia, like 5 kilometers to the city. You think it's not a rich suburb?
Not really.
Well, Stabrador is not a rich suburb. St. Lucia, rich suburb.
Okay.
That's some real estate fucking education for you. This is not real estate advice.
Should we get
into the news, or should we just ditch it entirely?
Nah, what do you got?
Deeds goes into voluntary administration. I knew about this because you sent it to me yesterday.
I paid $12 for a can of their Hellas once.
It was good.
It was okay.
Deeds were kind of like the kind of hypey craft brewery, weren't they?
Yeah. But that's another ATO squeezed them and that sort of thing. So that's kind of where that went. That was another thing as well. I saw
when you say squeeze them, we keep saying they're getting squeezed. It's a bill that they knew they'd have to pay that they didn't decided not to pay because they couldn't afford to pay.
Yeah. But
that's what it is.
Where the ATO wouldn't agree a payment plan, that sort of thing. So there was a really good one on ABC today. This is the thing. I think that the ATO's gone on this big tax collection rampage.
That's right? What the ATO does. It's their money that they're collecting from other people.
Yeah. But they're doing one as well on there was one about they're collecting taxes from personal income tax returns from over 15 years ago, where they've written off the tax, the debt, but now they've reopened them up and started collecting again.
So, right, but it's their money that they're getting from.
Yeah, but 15 years is a long time.
That is a long time. You don't fuck with the ATO. It's some yeah. taking. People think you can just take their money because they're the ATO. It's a fucking.
Yeah, I get it. I get it. Interesting.
Have you been to? I went to Deeds the last time I was in Melbourne. It was like very, very interesting.
I've never been there. No, what was it like?
Not very craft beery. I went there at night time. It was like a really fancy restaurant-y sort of vibe place, like in the suburbs. It was pretty unusual, actually. I kind of went there and I thought this is. It was like $20 a beer and. It was kind of like what craft beer could be if everyone was really rich and all the rich people love beer. But unfortunately, none of those things are true. So I kind of thought at the time, this is a little bit unusual. Maybe this won't work. I mean, obviously, I hope it does work. And maybe that's got nothing to do with it. But their offering was pretty elevated sort of offering for a beer business, I thought.
I used to brew their beer back in the day at Southern Bay in 2012. When they used to be called Quiet Deeds. They used
to I remember Quiet Deeds. Yeah.
So these they contract change. Brewed for ages. Sure, and it took them ages to get a brewery. So, but you know, there you go. Interesting.
Yeah. Well, hopefully they're right. And it's a bummer.
Yeah.
It's going to be more interesting is going to be what happens after all these VAs happen. Because it seems at the moment that everyone just has noticed that if you've got a debt that you can't pay, you can just go into VA. ATO will accept a deal and you get out of that ATO debt and try to treat your suppliers well and you can get on with business.
Critical mass.
But then what happens a year from now if the business, underlying business is not solid? We've never seen any of the numbers. Everyone's got an opinion on what's happening, but no one's seen any P&L from any of these businesses. And if the P&L is not good, a VA is not going to solve the problem.
Indeed.
Indeed. All right. Hey, I'll do the puns, all right?
Jesus. Rightio.
low carb VB, you got any opinions on this one?
I was very surprised to hear about that because I thought that VB already was low carb.
I also thought that.
So, yeah, I see Brews News is still operating.
Brews News are cranking out the content.
He's cranking it out, yeah.
Brews News, so, actually, when Matt Kirkengard retired, I took them off my list of websites I check before each episode. Actually, I put them down the bottom because I suspected there'd be still stuff to kind of go through. Now every week it's just loaded with content. Crazy. So I put it back on there.
I thought it was already low carb, but hey, you know.
Well, do they mention here the actual, it's just 33% less carbs, but that's, I mean, both have fuck all carbs, right?
Well, when you talk about
beer, the number of carbs in the
article. No, well, you talk about, when you talk about beer, and if you talk about a pot of beer and you talk about the carbs in a regular beer versus a low carb beer, it's a jelly bean.
Yeah. Okay.
That's it. So 33% less carbs. That's half a jelly bean.
It's all the rage, so they'll jump on the bandwagon. Taking them a while, though. The low carb thing's been a thing for a long time.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, decades, you know. But here we are, low carb VB, finally. Do you know the other interesting thing that's happening as well with VB?
Tastes like shit?
No, VX is coming out in regular size stubbies.
I don't know what any of that means.
VX, the 6% version of VB.
Oh, okay. Wow.
Yeah, because it was in tiny little grenade bottles.
Oh, yeah.
Right. And it's coming out in regular size bottles.
In a can, not in a can, in a 375.
That'd be cool too. That'd be cool too. But yeah. I didn't much like VX, but regular VB is good. I'll smash tins of that all fucking day sitting by the pool.
Okay.
You would too.
I'd be known to smash tins of 4X Gold, but it was
You hear about people like, you know, sitting by the pool and drinking literally an entire carton of VB by themselves. I can understand that.
Definitely used to do that on the boat with 4X Golds, but
yeah.
I feel like you'd be fuck-eyed if you drank any more than 4 or 5 VBs.
Well, didn't David Boone do it on a flight over to fucking from Sydney to London? He did like 40-odd something cans or something like that.
He did flight. 52, according to the tale. But
the legend, yeah.
Yeah, he was interviewed recently about it, and he's not proud of it. He's not a fan of that story, apparently.
Yeah, right.
I mean, it's Aussie legend, isn't it? You can't change facts of what happened.
Mm-hmm.
He probably, if anyone should have had 52 low carb VBs, though, it was Boonie.
Yes. Yes, absolutely.
Right. Well, if you see any of these in the bottle shop, go buy one. We'll do a live tasting on the podcast.
Yeah.
Dude, the people who drink, I follow those people on TikTok and I put them in the Hendo Reacts a few times, and all they do is purchase drinks. Like I can't even remember the names. All they do is purchase drinks and some of them like food that comes out.
Yep.
And that's all they fucking do. And they've just got like hundreds of thousands of followers and just get millions of views on all this shit.
What do they do?
Just taste shit. Like the hard solo, bring out a hard solo zero sugar.
No sugar.
I'll just taste that and do a video on that. Or like that, there's like an alcoholic juice out at the moment. They'll taste that and do some content on that. It's literally a couple of dudes. That Russ Eats guy, he doesn't. Mm. He's funny. And there's something Pause, which I think I've put on Hendo Reacts before.
Mm.
All they do is just taste drinks, get on video, and they've got this gigantic following.
Yeah, right.
That could be us, man. We need to get better at the reaction videos. That's the problem. Yeah, our reaction videos suck.
And short form content as well.
Yeah. Yeah. Definitely.
Yeah. That's where it's at.
I could edit this to do that, but couldn't be fucked. Yeah, but if you say something really insightful this episode, then maybe I will.
Yeah.
Speaking of insightful, Australia's brewed the perfect storm to put local craft beers out of business.
And you missed one.
Hey!
I just snuck one in there.
Where did that come from?
I snuck that in there.
It just slid in.
Yeah, just sliding into position number 3.
Okay, well, there you go. I did miss it because there's no warning and you've just put it in there at number 3.
Yeah, well, when you asked me before the show, is there anything you wanted to add?
And you said
that?
No.
Remember asking that?
And you said no.
I lied.
Well, why? Why didn't you just not lie?
Because I found that out after I lied to you.
Okay. This is at grainandgrape.com.au.
Yes.
Grain and Grape.
It's closing down.
Closing down on the 14th of May, which used to be when GABS was on, wasn't it? Around about then?
Around Good Beer Week, yes, and that sort of thing, yeah. So Grain and Grape is one of the more established homebrew shops in Melbourne, in Yarraville. And I actually saw this from a brewing colleague based in Melbourne who posted about it on Facebook. And I was quite shocked to hear that, actually. So John Preston, who owns Grain and Grape and has run it for like 35 years, he's getting to 65 years old. He wants to retire. And I thought he might sell the shop, but he didn't sell the shop. He just shut it down. And that's the end of it in May. The significance of that is so many brewing careers have started out of that shop, including mine.
Wow.
And, you know, when I was, when I was homebrewing, I would buy stuff, you know, living in Colac or in Geelong, I'd just get stuff mail ordered out from Grain and Grape. My Braumeister that I still continue to brew on this day that I've had it for over 10 years, that was from Grain and Grape, you know, and I brewed their wort kits there. Probably some significant brewers out of there. Brendan O'Sullivan from Three Ravens. He's been associated. He did demos there on Saturdays for God knows how long. And, you know, it's and they did system wars during Good Beer Week. I remember participating in a system wars where they had all these different homebrew systems, and you'd spin a wheel and you would get a different system. So there'd be like the Braumeister, and there'd be like the three vessel system.
To brew on,
yeah, on the
oh,
day.
Wow.
So all these professional brewers rocked up and they had to spin the wheel and brew on a particular homebrew system. So I spun the wheel and I drew the bucket of death.
Oh no.
And the bucket of death was basically plastic 15-liter bucket with an electric element in it.
That's not a good idea.
It was boiling wort in a plastic bucket. It was insane. It was so wow. Good. Made the best beer too. Made like a red IPA or something. And turned out all right.
Particles.
Yeah, that's fine, mate. You know, they're in everything now anyway. So
yeah, everyone's got a credit card inside their body.
Yeah, exactly.
You've
and
got
so,
more than that.
Yeah, it was really sad to hear. But you know, John's been very heavily involved in the Australian National Homebrew Conference, and that's coming up this year here in Brisbane, which is going to be really good. And and hopefully I'll get to see him I hope he comes up, because he's a bloody legend, John Preston is, and he doesn't realise the impact that he's had on Australian beer. So, you know, it's sad to see him close, but I get why he is, though.
Yeah, homebrew is such a big part of how people get into beer.
It's the transition from into professional brewing. Most always comes from homebrewing.
Yeah. Oh, it doesn't sound like a sad story though. If he's gotten to the end and he's kind of had a good run and wants to hang up the boots, that's, you know.
Nothing wrong with that.
Nothing wrong with that.
Mm.
That'll be you in 5 years.
Retiring.
Yeah. 65.
That'd be nice.
What would you do if you retired?
Probably teach full time.
True, that's not really retiring though, is it? It's just
working. Oh. Well, no, and then I'd probably do some philanthropy, I think. I would want to stay busy doing stuff, maybe sit on a board.
Yeah.
Even though I have no board experience. And
how hard could it be?
I don't think so. I don't think it's hard.
I don't think so either. Yeah. It's a fucking scam. Every board I've ever seen has been a complete scam.
Is it? Yeah, right.
Fuck. Let's not talk about that. All right. So I only put this in here. It's obviously a negative article. We're trying to stay away from them, but I've seen this posted a lot this week. This Channel 9 news article about this Australian craft beer.
Australia
industry.
Has brewed the perfect storm to put local craft beers out of business. Something's going on here. I think I'm just going to say that it's probably Kylie Lethbridge who is getting out and hitting and pounding the pavement with all of the media and that sort of thing.
Definitely. Yeah, well, so, she's mentioned in this article her photos.
Oh, she had photos in there as well, yeah. So, and so good on her. Good on her.
Yeah, well, definitely got some attention.
That was actually a really interesting article, because that very, I think I said in the comments in the Facebook group, which you can go and join at facebook.com/groups/ Boss and the Brewer. And this is actually the first article that I saw that painted a very clear picture about what happened with Hawkers.
Mm.
About the ATO basically foreclosing and sorting, forcing Hawkers into VA and wanting the money in 7 days and not negotiating on payment plans and stuff like that. So it's really interesting that article has been, you know, put out, and it paints that picture very clearly, and it sort of matches up with what I've been told privately and that sort of thing. And I hope that the word gets out more, but just drink more independent beer. That's all you can do.
I'm doing it right now.
I am too. I'm drinking a dented can. It's a dented can. I hope I don't get Alzheimer's or anything. Wow. But aluminium doesn't give you Alzheimer's, I don't think.
Oh, you think that is that? Wait, is that another pun?
Oh, that's very old thinking. That's like 1970s, like when you used to have aluminium cookware in it.
Well, but I've got a question. Inside a can, right, it's got a lining of
plastic,
right?
Yeah.
So like everyone who's drinking out of cans instead of plastic because of this whole microplastic situation, they're not going to be drinking out of
plastic. Yeah.
Plastic anyway.
Yeah.
Not this guy.
That is correct.
Glass bottles. Maybe there's going to be glass a resurgence bottles. Back to glass bottles.
Maybe.
Speaking of which, twisted shaft. Hendo, twisted shaft.
What the fuck is that?
It's a little shaft. It's in my bottle opener.
Okay.
All right. It's a mainly an audio podcast, so it's...
Yeah, that's probably good.
It's not going to land, but that's okay.
Yeah.
Pray for the best.
Here, watch this. Watch this. Want to see something cool?
Sure.
Okay, so we'll do a Hendo React, pre-React.
Oh, okay.
Here, watch this guy. Oh, what's going on here? There we go. So this guy, did I share sound?
I can't hear shit.
Alrighty, share sound. So he's basically this guy here. Can you see that? No, that's my fucking email. Let's try that again.
Well, I could see it the first time.
Okay, there you go.
Yeah. So,
can you see that?
Around it.
He's dissolving aluminium can in caustic soda. Cans.
Always wear gloves when dealing with drain cleaners. They're extremely toxic and poisonous.
What's toxic and poisonous? Check it
out. Oops, this one didn't work. Look at that.
Oops.
Everything spilled into the drain cleaner. And it's so hot. Wow, it's crazy. Ooh. Well, let's check this one. Look at that.
What's happening? What is happening?
He's put this, guys, the aluminium can very in caustic soda. And that's the plastic liner.
It's pretty hot.
What?
Actually. Yeah. This one is hot too.
Why
is
so basically what he's done?
Let me see if I can pour just from this cup right here without breaking.
So what he's done is he's dissolved the aluminium. Oh my god, that's so dangerous.
Oh, that's crazy.
And so that's basically dissolved the aluminium and there's the plastic liner.
Wow.
That's the inside of a can.
The first layer of the can is the plastic. That's pretty cool.
Amazing, isn't it?
That is amazing. So if you're trying to drink out of cans to stop your microplastic issue, then no point.
No, none. Not at all. Well,
glass. I just went glass into glass. I got the glass into glass twisted shaft. Oh, man.
I'm just drinking out of my plastic bag.
All right. What else we got here?
Oh, fuck.
Oh, GABS to relocate. Is this a problem for you?
I saw that too.
Have you booked travel for May?
Not yet, no.
Oh, okay. Well, that's lucky.
People
would have booked, right? That's only 2 months ago. 2 months
ago.
Yeah,
Joss booked.
Oh, no.
Yeah, she booked. So basically that week is not... I've just spilled my beer.
Fuck's sake. Hendo has left. I'm only talking now because I don't want to edit this podcast, especially the video. I suppose I could pause it. I couldn't be bothered. I'm going to watch everything that happens here. Oh, there he is.
Still
toilet paper or something.
I've got Bluetooth headphones and I can hear all the way out in the kitchen.
Okay.
You called me a bastard.
What did you do? Yeah.
I poured the beer too vigorously.
Okay.
And overflowed the glass.
Right.
Anyway.
Everything's fine.
So, yes, they changed the date and location of GABS.
Yeah, I saw the location. And that was the reason for the change, right?
The reason for the date change was the change of location. So basically, there's some urgent repairs required on the exhibition building, which is a beautiful, beautiful building, which really makes GABS Festival GABS Festival. I suspect probably what happened is they couldn't do all of the barbecues and indoor food maybe and that sort of thing. And so they had to move it, and so they moved it out to the showgrounds.
That's great. I heard what happened was they painted
in
it,
June.
But they didn't paint it half lexicon, and they got just a lot of complaints from the 12.
Mm-hmm.
That's the rumor I heard.
Maybe they're closing it to paint it the right color.
That's what I think they're doing. They're going to paint it the right color and get it right.
I'm pretty
sure I've been to a GABS out at the showgrounds before. Didn't they do one there a few years ago?
No, you went to one at the convention center.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So it was not that it was not at the that building.
That was the 2020 or 2021 one or something like that. Probably 2021 because it was none in 2020. And so that's so based, but out the showgrounds though, yeah. So it's been moved to mid-June as well. So but instead of being mid-May, it's been delayed a month. So I don't think I'm going to go to that. So not much trips happening to fucking Melbourne right now for old Hendo because I'm not due to go. I'm going to go down to Brownstone sort of thing and see the Kaiju boys and stuff like that. But I haven't seen I won't be no ABA judging for me this year. I'll go down for the dinner. Then the following week, pretty sure I'm going to be in Ho Chi Minh City and Bangkok, I think.
Scooting, probably.
Scootering, yeah. Yeah, scooter lessons, to be fair.
Nice. Yeah, well, I mean, that whole legendary trip of the Abers, the
GABS,
the kind of the Good Beer Week, all the content around there, the Pint of Origin, GABS,
there's no
the
good
whole
beer.
Thing.
There's no Good Beer Week. There's no GABS.
They're all dead.
It's Pint of Origin, and that's all that's there left.
Yeah. God, that sucks.
Sucks hard, man.
Yeah. But we're focused on positives, and we're moving on. Put Juicy. I saw something about Juicy night session cancel, but I didn't. There's no
that
article.
Is, yes.
Did that
yes.
happen? You would know about this.
Yeah, well, I had tickets to both sessions. I've got tickets to both sessions. Well, not the evening session. So they just due to a lack of sales, they cancelled the evening session of Juicy Festival. So now there's only the day session, but they're going to extend it for an hour. So it's going to be
5 hours of juiciness.
People are going to be so wasted there. Because he's going to get kicked out 3 times, I think, this year. And so they've knocked it back to one session. I actually reached out to Matt MacGyver from Range / Juicy. I actually asked him to come on the show tonight, just to sort of, because I'm a massive fan. I love Juicy Festival. It's so good. It's just so different to every other beer festival. It's like $150 for a ticket, but you don't pay for any drinks there, and that's phenomenal. And it just changes the whole dynamic of a beer festival. When you take the financial transaction out, all of a sudden there's no queues.
Yeah. Drinks. It's different. Yeah.
There's no tapping your card. There's no, you know, it's so basically Juicy Festival is so cool because you just go and hang out and just talk to the brewers and they just pour drinks and it's a good vibe and good music, good DJs and stuff like that. So, hopefully it'll bounce back next year. You never know.
What was it? So he said no to coming on the show, or
he's got all of the brewers. He's got a lot of international brewers and stuff like that in town. So he's sort of setting up, hanging out with them this evening and that sort of thing. So I said, look, next year, come on a few weeks before and we'll talk about it. He's like, yep, cool.
When is Juicy Fest?
Saturday, this Saturday.
Oh, wow. Shit. So they pulled the pin
the start of the week. Yeah.
Wow. Okay. That sucks. For them, I imagine. That would have had a lot lined up, venue and
things. Yeah, absolutely. I should make it down there. You know, it's like Adam Shell's birthday.
Which one?
This week. Both of them.
What? Okay. All of them.
Both of them. Adam Shell's birthday is tomorrow, and then the other Adam Shell's birthday is on Saturday.
Jesus Christ.
That took me for a bit of a loop, didn't it? It's like, which one? Both of them.
I definitely thought you were joking, like right up until.
No, I'm
like
not
the
joking.
Last
That's
seconds.
Is for reals. That is absolutely fucking for reals. Hell. So, I'm hanging out with Adam Shell on Saturday. So I might make it over to you. I got a ticket. If I go, cool. If I don't, like shit.
Yeah, you should. Yeah, well, it's going to be a fun day either way.
I've got a keg of Cooper's Sparkling homebrew that we brewed and it's tasting really nice. So we're going to drink that on Saturday just for shits and giggles.
That'd be a good time.
That's the plan.
Juicy. Well, it's hazy.
Yeah, well, that's the OG hazy. And it's got fruit in it. It's got banana in it. So, you know.
Nice.
And then tomorrow night, I'm taking some close friends out for a steak and red wine dinner. And
oh, yum.
Yeah, going over to local steakhouse here. And just as that was my reward for hitting my numbers in January with Tucky. So
nice. Can I ask where you're going? Are you worried you get stalked if you tell me? Because I'm not editing the show. Don't make me edit anything.
No. Don't tell me if you don't want to say. If you know, you know.
Okay. All right.
It's not that many places to get a good steak in Brisbane.
It's not
what? There's not that many places in Brisbane to get a good steak. So.
Oh, there's a few.
Yeah. And so that was like my reward for hitting my numbers in January, which I'm very happy about. And nice. I couldn't think of anything to like get myself. I really struggle with that.
Steak and red wine's perfect.
Yeah. And good friends and good company and that sort of thing. That's the things that I value. Like I've got all the motorcycles I need.
You don't need any more two-wheel.
I don't have a partner. I don't have kids or anything like that. So I don't have to buy anything for anyone.
Mm.
I already do plenty of overseas travel. So it's not like I want to go on a holiday or an overseas holiday or anything like that. I'd already do that, you know? And so spending some time with some good friends was all I could think of.
Sounds fucking awesome. Should we go Hendo Reacts? Let's talk about this real quick. This Cheers Act I saw on the Brewers Association website.
Right.
So this is something from America. I haven't really dug into the details of it, but it's basically a piece of legislation.
That beer line is coming out of that keg. Ugh.
Ooh, it looks like a... What is that, the liquid? That's, in it? Like, it's got bubbles gross. In it.
Yeah, it's got bubbles in it.
Yeah, it's basically a piece of legislation that encourages hospital venues to invest in keg.
They always give it. They always. You notice how they give the American legislation like some funny acronym, like the Patriot Act stands for something.
Cheers Act. That's fucking Cheers. Awesome.
It stands for Creating Hospitality Economic Enhancement for Restaurants and Servers.
Isn't that fucking awesome?
What does it do? What's it about?
It gives them. My understanding of it is it gives them sort of subsidies for putting in some kind of tap related stuff. So I assume putting in more efficient tap systems or whatever to encourage keg sales, basically. You give the venues money who are struggling, and then as a result, brewers get to sell more kegs as opposed to pack, which is better for the brewers. It's a pretty fucking innovative idea.
What a great idea.
Like would work pretty
Maybe
well.
They'll do that something here. If they 100%. If they did something like that here where... hospitality venues were given money to go and install a tap system on the proviso that it was independent beer or Australian-owned beer.
But even if it wasn't, there'd be no... If they put the tap system in, there would be no way for the majors to contract that part of the system.
No, that's right.
I mean, they would probably figure out a way around it. But in the short term, it gives them a way to put on beers that aren't... There's no incentive to put the majors on.
Well, they probably do things like umbrellas and merchandise and all that sort of shit. But
yeah, but I would, I mean, maybe it would be a venue that already has a tap system that they couldn't afford to put in that was put in by CEB and they could put a couple of extra taps on, that kind of thing. Because a lot of these breweries that are struggling post-COVID are not necessarily struggling to sell beer. They're just struggling with the idea that a huge chunk of what they sell and is now being sold in can. To the likes of Coles and Woolies, and they're getting squeezed that way.
Yes.
And it's harder and harder to sell keg because we've talked about them here all the time. There's just so many Bolter and Stone and Wood activations in all these massive venues. It's just impossible to get on tap any of these places. So if you can sort of increase the keg percentage for the breweries and help the venues out at the same time, it seems like a fucking good idea to me. I've never seen that talked about in Australia.
Yeah.
All we ever talk about is changing excise. Like this would actually help the industry. Changing 100%. Excise, I think, would not help the industry.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree. More outlets. Yeah. We're going to do Hendo Reacts.
Let's do Hendo Reacts.
We'll share sound. Audio. Here we
go. By the way, before you do this, all of these Hendo Reacts, except for the first one, have been sent to me this week.
Okay.
By members of the 12. I haven't had to do any work. Okay, you better click on it now because you got the preview there. I made this myself before the show. Okay.
A Snoop Dogg. I sense that's the new cover photo for the Facebook group, mate.
Sure, let's do it. She looks like she's popping out of my chest.
Yeah, well, it was all AI generated, wasn't it?
Well, it was definitely photoshopped.
Yeah.
All right, that can be the new Facebook group. Funny. You got to talk these through because most of our listeners are audio, remember. But anyway, okay, before we look at the next one, I just want to say thanks for the people who send these to me. So if you DM them to Boss and the Brewer on Instagram or just to me personally, thank you because it saves me work and this has been awesome. Next week, I'll make sure I shout out people's names who send them to me because this week I didn't. I just put them all. And then I got to the end, I'm like, holy shit, I've been sent all these. I've done nothing, but thanks to people.
No attribution.
I will attribute from next week on. Oh, I know a lot of them are called Luke. I know that much.
Yeah, rightio.
A lot of Lukes.
He sends me a lot of shit too. All right, Instagram. Here we go.
Okay, make sure sound is on.
House, same recycle.
I'm Jack Daniels. It's Jack Daniels. And Bottle Wise. Jack Daniels. I forgot the Jack Daniels.
Yeah. Every week, same house, same recycle.
So basically, it's a house that there's the back of the garbage truck is just bottles of Jack Daniels and Budweiser and that sort of thing. I'm halfway through on my birthday, Jack Daniels.
Oh, nice.
Ready? All right, let's have a look.
We've got content from everywhere this week.
Running a bike this way is dangerous as high RPM wheel can hit the ground and send the bike forward, causing
damage. Okay, that's just a disclaimer. But look at the title. How okay.
This is shows. This is actually really good.
Yeah.
It shows how the CVT works on a scooter. And so basically you've got the variator at the front and you've got the clutch and the contra spring at the back. And it's like infinite gears. You got to rev it? Yeah, there we go. So the variator goes in, he goes up. That's how fast my scooter goes.
So that variator there, that's like shaped like a cone, right?
The front one, the front part.
Yeah, the front one.
Yes.
So when that goes in... The front cog is bigger and therefore it moves more.
That is correct. So how it works is on the back part of the variator, there are some little roller weights. And as it spins, it pushes the backing plate apart and presses presses the variator closer together.
Yep.
Which then raises the belt up, which makes the front gear get a higher higher gear, and then you notice that the back one on the clutch plate, it's like your bicycle, you know, like on the back gear on your bike, if it's on the big cog, it's low gear, and if it's on the small
it moves
cog,
as well. I didn't even notice that.
So there's a contra spring there, so it's infinitely variable gears and that sort of thing. So and because the belt is a constant length, that's kind of how it works. Very, very cool. That was really dangerous. But
yeah,
that's how scooter clutch works, or scooter transmission works. So very, very cool. Who sent that through? That was pretty good.
Well, that's the thing. I didn't write any of these people down. I'm sorry.
It was informative.
Yeah, it was very good. Someone called Luke, I'm guessing. Very good chance.
It's like a double dry hop, galaxy, hoppy, dank, hazy, New England, juice bomb, high elevation cryo, double IPA.
ADHD
can
it look is
like
awesome.
Rich water mixed with orange juice? Can it smell like a frat room floor at 3 a.m.? Can it have a punny name? Optimus Prime, George Papadopoulos. Love it when you call me Big Hoppa. Haze to La Vista, baby. Can it be in a 16-ounce can? Can the artwork be super goth, like zombies with swords rising from a bog? Ooh, you got any quads? Those are great. They give you a hangover while you're drinking them. Hey, perfect. Haze for days. I'm just going to take a few pics and send it to all my friends. They all have beards for some reason. Hey there. It's like a double dry hot galaxy, hoppy, dank, cool. Hazy New England.
That's pretty funny.
That's pretty much how. That's going to be Juicy Festival on Saturday, I think.
Yeah.
Instagram.
Kim Formula One, we're racing in Saudi Arabia in Jeddah. It was a down-packed super speed race in the Middle East. Remind me, somebody tell me who won. Red Bull 1-2, really, what a shock.
car be giving them wings. Domination matter, watch max 13 seconds in front of Checo, it's over and I can't see another constructor getting closer. Ferrari, Chelsea made it to the podium, didn't have signs to compete to speak and roll with them. Stand up, Holly Behrman, you're a king. Points in his first ever race, that's a win. Oscar Piastri really making a stamp. Fourth for the Aussie and McLaren got a world champ. Nando Alonso chilling in fifth. Russell and Mercedes playing catch up in sixth. Next Lando, eighth, Lewis, nine, Hulk, ten. DNF for Stroll and Pierre Gasly in the end. Ocon drove better than his car could have given him, and Danny Rick deserves a better seat. I recommend a new rule. Verstappen starts a lap behind. Really see what everybody else can do with their time. I'm only kidding, now we got a week off to enjoy. Till I see you in Australia, where Melbourne making noise.
This oh, man.
So that was now, that was two of your favourite things combined. Yes. At least two.
Yeah, what? Snoop Dogg and Formula One?
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. Man, I wish I was going to the Formula One in Melbourne.
Oh, damn it. Me too. I am going to the Suns this weekend, though.
Are you?
Yeah.
Are you going to have a pie with tartare sauce on it?
Yeah, well, I don't
think so. Rallis is one of the 12. He's listening.
Rallis is a very dodgy individual who eats tartare sauce on everything.
Yes.
And I haven't forgiven him for that. And no. That's all we have to say.
Especially sitting in the Carlton fans area and then going dropping $400 on Suns merch and yeah. making us wear it.
And then by the end of the game going
he was friends
Carlton.
With them all.
Yeah. Best mates with all of them.
Best mates with everyone. It was just so good.
That was good. It was a good time. So actually this is the first time I'm going since we went to that game. So I'm going with my kids. It's gonna be fun.
Yeah. That's awesome. Love man.
But yeah, it would be good great. To go to the F1.
But he's awesome. Especially going to the bloody Carrara. All right, what's the next one here? HR6. We'll talk about Formula One in a minute.
What have we got? Oh, here we go. Oh, three Hello. People say this to me.
Hello. My name is Frank Walker from National Park. Hello. My name is. Hello. My name is. Hello, my name is Frank Walker from National Piles. Our famous annual spring sale is on now. Beautiful wall of floor tiles slashed by up to 40%. Eureka outdoor paving tiles up to 50% off.
So
the
good.
Very latest designer border tiles up to 60% off. But you'll have to be quick. So rush into the National Tiles famous annual spring sale now and save.
Very, very good.
National Tiles. David Street, Richmond, Melbourne Street, Bayswater, and Princess Highway, Dandenong. Also Ballarat and Geelong. Hello.
My name is
Hello.
That's very
That's
good.
That's good. Three people very, sent very that good. To me. Thank you, all the yeah. Lukes, for sending that.
Very, very good. Very, very good.
Oh, last TikTok. One, HR8. Oh, no, seven.
Seven? TikTok?
TikTok before it gets banned. We can still use it, hopefully.
Price for Australia.
Oh, this graphics are good.
Guys.
Sorry.
Come on.
Okay, broccoli.
$10
for a broccoli.
We can put it on special.
How much?
Well, $10. We'll just write special on it.
Can you still feed your family for under $10?
Shut the fuck up.
What about cheese?
Oh, no, like 12, but 13, 14 bucks.
Good work.
Because inflation's been so tough.
Ah, yeah, really tough.
Feel free, right? Yeah, how can anyone get ahead in this market?
Tough.
What?
This is embarrassing. I've just gone and bloody had a record profit again. Oh, I stick on the notice board. No one really cares anyway.
Way to go, pal.
You know what? Let's go green.
Finally.
No more plastic bags. Only paper.
Something's missing.
Well, we're going to charge you 20 cents for
it. It's not like paper grows on trees.
I mean, they kind of are. Putting avocados from the brown onion. So it's still money from innocent Australia.
No, I'm here for the meeting. Would anybody like to buy a vacuum?
Piss off! You're not welcome!
I'll be the same.
Fuck hate German.
So good.
How good is funny TikTok?
That was good. All right, speaking of Gervais.
Speaking of healthy beer choices. It's not the same video as the other week. It's similar.
...of Dutch Barn...
Wait.
Hi, I'm Ricky Gervais, co-owner of Dutch Barn Vodka, and with me today, Dr. Patterson. Now, this is an advert, so you're not a real doctor.
No, I'm an actor.
Now, you like a drink, don't you?
Absolutely.
What do you drink?
Beer.
I think vodka is probably better than beer in terms of calories per unit of alcohol. So, although I doubt it'll make a dent in you, you're fat because you eat too much, aren't you?
No exercise.
You won't be laughing. You have to have your feet removed from diabetes.
No, probably not, no.
No, fat cunt. Hi.
Oh, God. That's so good.
All right.
It would be the best to shoot videos with, hey?
Oh, my God. It'd be so funny. All right. Yeah. Stop screen sharing. That's it. HR8.
Can I wee first?
Yeah, you can wee. Well, let's do a little pausey boo here. Let's
go. Rightio.
There we go.
I'll be right.
Hello.
My name is. It's in my head now.
Oh, yeah. That is good. Oh, by the way. Oh, no, actually, no. I'm not going to say anything. I've got a surprise for next week.
Okay, cool.
Surprise for next week, the Hendo reacts. So let's get into these 12 questions. You can't look. What are you looking at? You can't look at these. That's cheating.
I'm not looking at
that, right? All right. So every week we put a question in the group, facebook.com/groups/BostonTheBrewer, of which we have 352 members now, which is quite cool.
Wow. We're almost popular.
And we ask them for questions. Some of them are complete shite because we kind of encourage that. So we can't really blame people for that. Sometimes I ignore them completely, which I did the other week when we had Feathers on. That was my fault.
Yep.
Sometimes we actually read through them, which is what we're going to do right now. Luke Cooper, who I think was one of the ones who sent me the memes for Hendo Reacts, says, comment, positivity only. We've been pretty good with that, I feel. Do you think, this episode?
I think we've been positive.
We mentioned the VAs, but we kind of skimmed it. We glossed over it.
I feel positive.
I feel positive. I feel pretty good after these two belly brewing beverages. Luke Cooper, a lot of local breweries are celebrating untapped success this week.
Yes, I saw that.
I saw a little bit of that. I thought the platform was a thing of the past, but obviously still popular. Who do you think benefits from the app the most, and what could it do better? Wow. This actually surprised me. I don't even know if I even have this on my phone anymore. I'm going to check right now.
Yeah.
I do have it on my phone. Do you have it on your phone?
No, not anymore. I haven't had it for years.
These breweries. Here we go. Oh, wait. Our first ever Untapped Community Awards. So that's probably why.
Yes.
We get medals to 25,000 beers across. Oh, that's a good idea. Yeah. I like that.
Oh, look, you know, as a professional brewer, I don't much like Untapped. It's just pretty trash.
So Untapped, you click on the link to look at who won, and it takes you immediately off the app and then takes you to a website on the browser.
Yeah.
You've gone to, and then you have to select a style.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm probably not doing that. I'm not doing that. I'm out.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wait, Australian sparkling ale. Let's see what's. How's the Serenity beat Cooper's? Oh, there you go.
There you go.
That's an idea that should have happened 10 years ago, isn't it?
Awards. Yeah. Good 100%. Idea. Yeah. Untapped has some fundamental problems from an industry perspective is that, you know, you can't update your beers unless you pay or something like that. And the community, yeah, it's just, I don't know.
Untapped is like Foursquare for it's like the niche of the niche of the niche. It's like these platforms just don't really exist anymore. It's very, very, very niche.
It's not Foursquare. It's more like Yelp.
No, it's Foursquare because you go to the venue and you check into the venue and you rate, you know, it's like one of those apps that when you first got your phone, it was like, this is going to be awesome.
What part of the internet is that from? Is that like 50-year-olds internet?
What are you talking about?
You're about to turn 50, aren't you?
If it was a 50-year-old, hey, don't use my bit against me, all right? My bit. You wait, there's something coming with that too, so just don't get too cocky now. I think breweries probably got some good news and they wanted to share it, and that's cool.
Yeah, but I think it's
cool. I don't think it means people care about it.
I don't think much of the platform, but, you know, if breweries want to celebrate it, cool.
You know when I stopped using Untapped?
When?
When I rated Lee's chocolate stout back in the day. Mm-hmm. I gave it like a 3 out of 5 and I said I didn't really like it. It's too sweet. And he got real mad at me and I was like, yeah, actually that is a fucking shit thing to do. Well, I didn't really know him at the time, but now I know him.
Yeah.
And then I was like, that is
shit. Well, then what you do, you know what you do now that you know Lee,
mm-hmm.
is you drink the chocolate stout again and drink it in like front it. Of him. Drink, no, like no, it. Exactly. It doesn't matter. Drink it in front of him, not like it. Get your phone out and oh, fucking no. look him in the eye as you tap three caps.
Oh, Jesus.
Assert dominance, that's mate.
So aggressive.
Assert dominance.
Should I, like, piss on the floor at the same time or something? Or
yeah, maybe.
Wow, this is so aggressive. We should do a field trip to go see Lee, and I'll tap in his thing and untap.
Great idea. Absolutely.
Okay. Right. Wait. To answer the question, who do you think benefits from the app the most, and what could it do better? The app's dead, surely. I think it's the app's dead.
It's dead.
All right, Corey Cooper. What? How many fucking Coopers want to ask questions in this thread? Jesus.
And what do we call Corey?
Do you guys eat healthily?
Yeah, I try to. I'm on a bit of a fitness regime, as you know.
Yeah.
And I smashed through 120 kilos on the trap bar this week, which I'm really happy about.
Wait, talk me through that.
You know what a trap bar is?
Is it the bendy one?
No, it's the one that you step in and you lift up either side.
Oh, yeah.
The one that Hugh Jackman does. Yeah. So like Hugh Jackman. I do the same exercise as Hugh Jackman.
Basically Hugh Jackman.
Hugh Jackman, but no hair, exactly.
You can do the things, can't you?
I could do that if I wanted to, but I don't want to.
Yeah, okay.
And so I did 120 kilos in that. When I first started at the gym last year.
What do you do? What's the movement?
It's deadlift.
Oh, deadlift, okay. Yeah.
Deadlift.
Nice.
So three lifts of 120 kilos. Actually, I can find out what I did when I started, actually.
Once again, answering the question at all. But
what was the question?
Do you eat healthily?
Yeah, I try to. Yes. Yes, I like to think, here we go. So I started on the trap bar 65 kilos. And I could barely do it. And now I'm doing double that. Yeah.
Amazing.
That's huge. Eh?
Now, do you eat the trap bar?
It's got a lot of iron in it.
Just to get back to the question that you were asked about the food again.
So eating healthily for me at the moment is a very high protein diet at the moment.
Especially tomorrow night.
Yeah, absolutely. So, like, I went through a bit of a period last year where I was, like, not eating at all and lost a lot of weight. And it's not healthy and that sort of thing. But now that I'm, you know, working out, I've got Cohen, my personal trainer. He's a fucking legend. And, trying to be healthy, you know, and eating healthy and lots of exercise and, you know, going to the gym three times a week, which I enjoy it, you know. It's just good just to, like, I'm not a morning gym person. I really can't do gym in the mornings, but
yeah.
I start work early in the morning, you know, like I'll get up at 5:30 and I'll be sitting at the desk at 6.
Wow.
And start working.
That is early.
But I'll finish at 12:30, 1 o'clock, you know.
Nice.
And go to the gym. And if I feel like going back to work, I'll go back to work. And if I don't feel like going back to work, well, I'll just call it quits for the day and go do something.
Hey, you know what's happening tonight? Totally fucking unrelated to anything. But
is it maths?
You're not answering it. No. Starship third launch is happening tonight. Possibly happening tonight.
Really? Possibly. What time?
7 a.m. CT, which I think is like an hour and a half from now.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Yeah, an hour and a half from now is when the window opens.
Are they going to get in and try and get it into orbit again?
I assume so. I think they made a lot of improvements to it. So depending on the weather and lots of other things, it could happen tonight.
Okay.
Anyway, that doesn't answer your question. And I fucking love food so much. I eat so much food. I eat nonstop all day.
Mm-hmm.
Today I had like avocado and corn thins as a snack at work. And then like an hour later, we started making boiled eggs. So I just randomly eat boiled eggs at work. And then we had a beef and black bean thing that Erin made last night. Tonight she made some crazy thing in the rice cooker, a whole meal in the rice cooker.
Oh, that's good when you do that.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know anything about that, but I'm sure it's awesome. I'm going to eat after this. I don't know if it's healthy. I don't know. I fucking love food.
Yeah.
Probably not, really, to be honest. I eat fucking anything. Next question. Adam Shaw, question, over under on Batby getting the media prize at the ABERS?
I would probably, I reckon, if there was an over under on Boston the Brewer versus Aussie Beer Voyage.
No, it's not going to be either of those two, I'm pretty sure. Yeah. I mean, actually, no, Aussie Beer Voyage would deserve it.
Yes.
Above us for sure.
Yes.
It would be cool.
You're implying that we entered.
What's that?
We didn't enter.
No, I'm not implying we entered. Adam Shell asked a question. Mm. We talked about it last week.
Yes.
So he's saying over under on Batby getting them. Well, that must mean he entered, right?
Yes, I would say so. I think we should probably do an over under on Bozzy Beer Voyage getting the ABA Media Award.
Yeah, to be honest, I think what they're doing is good. Going around to the breweries, doing video content.
Yeah.
Unbiased.
It's getting way better. Right? It's turned more into a podcast, and it's really slick now. I actually did another interview with Adzi last Friday about the Royal Queensland Beer Awards in my capacity as the chairman of judges.
Yeah.
And fancy fucking title, but here we are. And it's just slick. Just like the Adzi's really gotten good at asking good questions, and Joel's just doing some really good stuff with, you know, he's sort of involved behind the scenes, and yeah, they're doing really good.
I think also just the video content is really key, because no one is doing that well.
Mm.
And that was really a missing thing. I'm just going to see if I can bring up this article real quick. 10 years best media. So let me have a look. So Kirkengard.
I was in the people who won the media award at the RBAs. Yeah.
Luke Robinson, 2015. 2016, Glenn Humphreys, James Atkinson, 20. Okay, because I was going to say he might win for the podcast, because his podcast is very solid, but he's already won it twice. So
yeah, right.
Probably unlikely to win again, I guess. Will Zeebel. I mean, Crafty Pine have been doing an amazing job after the whole Bruce News thing. They've been cranking out the news regularly.
But they sponsor that award.
Claire Burnett, she was great. That's a good one. Mick Weiss won it last year, so I think he was the one who wrote the article. Yeah, interesting. I wonder who is going to win that award.
Mm.
That why the fuck not? That they could win it.
Mm, mm.
I mean, I'm not going to put my flannel on the line for it, but I think the odds are probably reasonable.
Yeah, I think so. We don't know who else has entered, but hey.
Yeah. Here we go. Robert Donaldson. Right. How good was Newcastle Beer Fest on the weekend? And he's put a little link here. Oh, here's a video. Wait, okay, wait. Jesus Christ.
Stick it in Hendo Reacts.
Put this in the Hendo Reacts. This is a video. Oh God. I hate to think what we're gonna.
Is it what is it
gonna happen
it,
here?
I'll put it in Hendo Reacts. I'll share my screen.
Can I DM it to you on Facebook?
That'll work.
I've just DM'd it to you on Facebook. We did Hendo Reacts to this video. It's a last minute Hendo Reacts. Surprise Hendo. It needs audio.
Oh.
Surprise HR number 9.
All right, here we go.
Newcastle Beer Fest.
Mr. Sam.
Wait, this is shocking road rage moment. Like
I'm Mr. Rainford Brewing. We've been at this festival since day one, 2014, when it was down the museum, then the boardwalk, then Camp Shortland, now here at King Edward Park. It's the best festival in the country. You're not here, what's going on? Get down here. Let's go. Next year's 10. Yeah.
I'm Chris from Mountain Culture. We're here from the Blue Mountains at Newcastle Beer Fest and ready to pour you some thick, juicy boys.
Scotland. Juicy boys.
We're in the setup phase here. Heaps of breweries, heaps of good food, heaps of good music. Most of all, it's a good travel lager. See you, Danny. Give me a test.
Hey guys, Chris here from Lord Nelson Brewery. Second day for a beer. Come down for
coffee. Oh, nice.
Hey legends, from Young Henry. It is a ripping day for a beer.
Hey guys, Brandy from Beef Brewery. Come all the way down from Darwin. Sun's out, cracking day. Right. Come down for a couple of beers at Newcastle Beer Fest.
G'day everyone.
Doors are about to open. Festival's about to kick off. Come drink some beer with us. Come check out our stand. Have a look.
That's
at
exactly what my kid Jordan's going to look like in like 10 years' time.
Weather is perfect. Come drink.
Hey, he needs to get under the shade immediately.
Yeah,
yeah.
Beer Fest. Doors are open now. Tickets are ready. Come on down. Have a beer with us. Hey, guys. I'm Dan from Bass Point Brewing in Shell Harbour. Come on down to Newcastle Beer Fest today. Have a beer with us. Sun's shining. Good day.
Hey, there, Hunter.
Hey guys, it's Scotty from Notus. We're brewed in Merriweather. Come on down to King Edward Park.
Audio is really not good.
The background music, not much ducking.
For a nice warm day, get around it.
Hey guys, how you doing? Josh here from Burgerhead. We've come up all the way from Sydney. We cooked some great burgers. Bloody brilliant day. Come on down to Newcastle Beer Fest. Grab your tickets.
Nice, I like them. It's like Aussie beer voids for the...
It is.
We're at the Beer Festival, San Jose's and Chicken Carago. Come down, the sun is shining.
I think that. Yeah, so we've had our record this year. I think I did eat that at your birthday
party. Who was that guy?
Ticket sales.
That's from you.
We're picking it for 3,000. We're going to cap it out. So very, very excited. That audio is quite
good.
But it looks like a good
big crowd.
I was like, how they
too sweet. Zigzag. Big crowd.
Oh, it's cranking in there. Jesus.
Hey, big boy.
Wow.
That was it.
Hey, big boy. Yeah.
Okay, don't feel... That was the road rage one. Okay, well, that's good. That was cranking. That looked good.
That looked pretty good.
A good time.
That looked pretty good.
Stop sharing. Worry about what I'm going to see on your YouTube history.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
I mean, thank you for that comment. It's good. Okay.
Yeah, that was good.
Kalani Fuller. How come Australian brewers can't brew beers like Americans can? Just got back from the US this week. They're on another level. Wow. Yeah, well, that's interesting. I mean, my whole thing when we started Black Ops was like, I went to America. It's next level. We need to do something like that here.
Yes.
I was fucking blown away. Haven't been back since. That was 2015, I think.
Yep, yep.
That surprises me to read that. I mean, maybe they are still fucking just dominating.
Yeah.
It's possible. I think it's also not just the product, is it? Like the whole culture there is.
Yeah, I like the bar culture. Just being able to go into a place and sit at the bar and get served by someone in a bar. We don't do that here, you know. We don't have bar service. We don't have like, you know, that real traditional kind of thing. Bars aren't for sitting at in Australia, and I really wish they were.
But even sports, like the sports thing they got going, even like the small town, the amount of taps like restaurants have. Craft beer just got everyone in Australia thought it was going to get to where America got to. And it didn't.
Got close.
It didn't really get close. I don't know
about that.
You think it got close? Different.
Just different.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Well, that's interesting to hear that. Fuck, maybe need another US trip then.
We should go together.
100%. Go to the Vegas Grand Prix.
That sounds messy.
Watch your boy Carlos Sainz run over some fucking drain.
Yeah, drop 10 grand on a ticket.
did you watch the Drive to Survive? I just finished it.
Oh no, I haven't finished it yet. I've got to finish watching that.
It ends like right at the end. He says, "Fuck sake." That was like the end of the whole thing. Sorry to spoil it. But you know, the end, it's like a memoriam to, because it, okay, I'm not going to say anything. I'm not going to say anything, but it was good. It was good. Okay. I've been consuming so much F1 content. I've been really into it this year.
Yeah, 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 yeah. I enjoyed the race last weekend. It was pretty good.
Yeah, except for Ricardo.
He didn't have a good week.
He had a fucking horrific race.
Yeah.
He's worse than everybody except for the cars that shouldn't even be there.
Yeah. He's all right. He'll get on it.
You reckon?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
I think I've lost my confidence.
After two races, that's...
No, 5 years of everything that's happened since you left Red Bull.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm playing F1 2023 on PlayStation.
How's that going? Is that good?
It's not bad.
I saw you'd racked up some hours on it.
That was Days Gone.
Oh, okay.
Oh, fuck.
This is what you do at 12 o'clock in the afternoon.
No, yes. But so Days Gone on PS4, and now I've got the PS5. They upscaled it to 4K. Oh, my God. It's just, I just played through the thing again. The fourth time I played through Days Gone.
And I and the PlayStation 5 tells you on the screen how many on the home screen how many hours you played. And I had no idea.
You don't want
PS4
that.
Doesn't tell you. And so on days gone, 242 hours.
That's 10 days straight.
So dumb. So dumb.
You know, until you look at how much time you spent on your phone. Like,
yeah. 242 hours. And the second game, highest game, would be The Last of Us Remastered. And I literally just bought today The Last of Us Part 2 Remastered for PS5. So it's on 4K and 60 frames a second and all that sort of shit.
I don't really understand many of those words. It sounds great, though.
Yeah, it's good.
Jared Gunion, question, thoughts on GABS Melbourne, new venue and date. The date sucks. Do you know much about the venue? It probably sucks.
It's going back to its roots, not GABS, but beer festivals in Melbourne. When I first went to, I can't remember what it was called. It was the Melbourne Beer Festival, I think it was called, and it was at the Showgrounds. That was my very first beer festival in like 2008, I think it was. Rode my motorcycle down from Danthorpe. Melbourne. I'd never been to Melbourne before.
That's simply too far to ride a fucking motorcycle.
I rode a motorcycle down, yep. And it was my original, rode it down, rode it back. It was pretty good. So yeah. Just enjoyed being on the bike.
Good venue?
No. Look, it's just a space.
I've been to some GABS at some shitty venues and it's still a fucking good time. It'll be fine.
Yeah. It'll be fine. It's GABS.
Yeah, it'll be good. But
when's the Brisbane GABS?
That was normally around June, wasn't it?
Yeah. Let's have a look. GABS Festival 2024. Festivals.
That's June. That's June. Wait, when was the Melbourne GABS? 14th of June.
Oh. Ah.
Night session. Wait, GABS to relocate. Weekend before. It's a weekend before Melbourne GABS.
Is that right? Wow.
That sounds like a challenge.
That's a big ask.
I feel like that's doable.
To move the whole of GABS in a week.
No, I just meant as a consumer.
Yeah. Well, I'm not going to go down for it, but.
All right. Phil Sharp, getting some graffiti done at the Lexicon Half Walls at Hiker. Guess the name of the character for the disabled toilet. I don't know if I really want to. This sounds like this is going to be problematic. We've got. Not that one, the other one. She in charge of the hops. There's a person with a broken leg. Oh, that's cool. It's in the toilet door. And there's a koala.
Oh, I can't see that.
You want to see that? Fuck's sake. Here, I'll just share
your screen. Are you going to share your screen?
Yeah.
Oh, I'll let you share your screen. Yeah. There you go. Now you can share your screen.
Share screen. Google Chrome. There you go. I'm not going to do audio because it's just a photo.
Oh, my God.
You have to guess the name of this character here with the crutches and the...
Wow, that's really impressive. Don't know.
Don't know either, but the koalas have faces and she does not have a face.
No, not yet anyway.
Could be unfinished.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Well, let's get out of that. Cool. They need to put a little screen up in front of that, though, right? Because you sit at the bar and you can see people.
You can see the toilets. Yeah.
Yeah. I don't want to see your piece. You know what I mean? I just want to drink in peace.
Yeah.
All right. Stephen Kegel, question. Who's going to Juicy this Saturday? Thoughts on the night session? Well, you may go there. You feel like a little non-committal.
I'm not non-committal. If I make it, I make it. If not, that's fine.
That's fair. Question, Bo Curtis. Oh, Q question, colon, space, colon, space, predictions for most out there GABS festival brews. Can't say. Yeah, that's
too early.
What about the brewers that were brewing for May? They would have been thinking about that already, right? And potentially brewing for it, maybe?
Well, yeah. When's Sydney GABS?
Depending on what it was.
Yeah.
When does Sydney GABS?
So even the dates aren't on the fucking website at all.
That's 31st of May. Interesting. So people very well could have been brewing beer for that now, right?
Maybe. Maybe.
I mean, if it's something crazy, it's probably going to hang around just fine, but...
Yeah.
If it's anything you want fresh, it's not going to be a deal.
Yeah. Yeah, oh, here we go. Oh, no, it's 2023. Don't know.
Predictions. Let's wait and see. We need to do over and under, but this episode's already gone for 15 hours. So,
yeah.
Okay. I want to win, though. I'm sick of losing. I've lost the last two and it bugs me.
Yeah. Yeah. Anyway.
Any predictions for the Aussie GP?
Not yet. We can probably talk about that next week because that's when it's on.
2 weeks. You missed it. You decided not to do the Max Verstappen bet last week.
No.
And I'm going to withdraw it because I don't want any part of that nonsense. Okay.
Rightio.
But you had a chance to take the whole thing out if you had taken that deal, I feel like. Which was he wins more this year than last year.
Have you withdrawn?
I'm withdrawing it. After two wins down, I'm not going to even make that offer anymore.
Yeah, right. Shit, eh?
I think it's almost a certainty at this point.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely.
All right, that's it. Enjoy your steak and red wine and possible appearance at Juicy Fest.
So easy, mate. Catch you next week.
If I put that Frank Walker music at the end of this episode, do we get copyright struck or not?
Probably, yep.
Do it anyway?
Nah, don't get copyright struck, man. Don't want to lose the YouTube channel.
That's fair. I also would require me to do some editing. I don't really want to do that.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. Cheers, mate.
See you next week.
See you next week.